Before the break, we asked, what is the annual economic impact of snowmobiling in Canada? If you answered C, $6 billion, you were correct.
Today we're taking a look at the new TOBE technology lineup. TOBE has actually been around for about 11 years now, but has been developed over in Sweden. This is its second season in the North American market, and already we're getting a lot of hype about it. Some very, very bright colors, as you can see. Some unique zippers that they're using, a open course zipper with a rubberized waterproof coating on all of them. They're using now what's called a Dermazax material in their TOBE 2.0 lineup. Dermazax is a very, very high-end material. It actually gives it a lifetime waterproof guarantee. If you ever find that water comes through that material, they will replace that jacket or pant or garment at no questions asked. So very, very high-end materials. TOBE is designed to use with a layering system. So more driven towards the mountain market, but if you are using a layering system in your standard trail riding, it works very, very well. It's just against kind of all of our traditional thoughts. Now one thing, as you can see, is they have a one-piece suit. One-piece suits are maybe a thing of the past, but I personally actually tried a one-piece suit last year out in Revelstoke, BC. I thought it was actually the most comfortable suit I've ever tried. Could never get snow coming in because there's no seam, no need for a snow skirt. Felt like you're just floating in the suit. One unique thing about TOBE actually is they've actually driven a lot of the design and the function from the ski and snowboard world and put it into the snowmobile world. They have very unique ventilation system. For instance, on this jacket here, the vent is actually up near the front, so you get a lot of intake air coming in. Well, guys in the mountains generally are all wearing a backpack. So you have a backpack on, traditional snowmobile jacket has a vent across the back. It has it underneath the arm. You have to take the backpack off to actually open those vents or close the vents. So they've done a lot of thinking, put the vent up above the backpack strap line, so it's very easy to access. So a lot of thought and design goes into this product line to make it unique aside from all the rest of the products out there. Very unique line, as I said. Check it out. It's got some real neat stuff, and again, very bright colors.
Having seen so much change in the last decade, it's hard to believe it's been 10 years since Yamaha introduced the RX-1, the industry's first high-performance four-stroke powered snowmobile. Many pundits scoffed at the four-stroke machine, but time has proven them wrong, and going into the 2013 model year, Yamaha is clearly focused and dominant with four-stroke power driving the future.
Yeah, we've been building sleds for 45 years now. You know, we got into it in the 60s, and you know, we did real well in racing and overall volume, and really, you know, put our meat hooks into the industry, and that's apparent because there's only four left today, where we had 400 back in the 70s. 11 years ago, we came out with four strokes, now that we've launched 2013, but, you know, we expected the whole industry to move to four strokes, and it's now finally starting to happen. Arctic Cat's come out with more four strokes, and they're actually outselling their two strokes. Our core market is four strokes. We make primarily because they're more dependable and more reliable, and they last a lot longer. We found that in motorcycles, and we found that in ATVs, and it's true for snowmobiles.
Be it early days with two-strokers or the more current four-stroke models, one attribute Yamaha has always been known for is their product dependability.
That surprised me this year. You know, we have our top 20 that everyone looks at, and usually it's performance, handling, and comfort. This year it's performance, comfort, and durability. You know, they want them to last. They're paying more money for sleds nowadays. The other thing about durability is when you go to trade it in, typically they're worth more. If you have a really high quality, durable machine that will last a long, long, long time, it'll resell for more than ones that don't. So, you know, we were real excited when we saw that on the survey. So, because we nail the three. You know, we have really good ride comfort, we have really good durability, and we do have performance.
Given that every manufacturer now builds four-stroke snowmobiles, it's safe to say that the Yamaha RX-1 was a sled that truly changed the direction of snowmobiling. Yamaha's first snowmobile was the SL350, and the first snowmobile was slide valve carbureted. What year was it released? The answer when we return. Up next on STV, it's all about you.